Hello students, welcome back to the chapter D and F block elements. In the previous video lecture, we learned about preparation and chemical properties of potassium dichromate. In today's video lecture, we are going to learn preparation, chemical properties and structure of potassium permanganate KMnO4. This is also one of the important concepts and the preparation is asked for 3 marks. Let us begin our today's session. Preparation of potassium permanganate KMnO4. It involves 2 steps. In the first step, we are going to prepare K2MnO4, and which is from pyrolusite ore, that is MnO2. Pyrolusite ore is fused with alkali base, that is KOH or NaOH or K2CrO3, in presence of oxidizing agent like KNO3 or KClO3. In presence of air, it gives K2MnO4. Let us learn the reaction. We have MnO2, that is pyrolusite ore, which is treated with alkali base KOH in presence of oxygen, gives rise to K2MnO4, and the name of K2MnO4 is potassium manganate. And there is a liberation of water molecule as a byproduct. So this is the first step. This reaction you can remember. 2MnO2 plus 4KOH plus O2 gives rise to 2K2MnO4 plus 2H2O. In the next step, we are going to oxidize K2MnO4 into KMnO4, that is in acidic or neutral medium. We take ionic equation MnO4 2-, that is from K2MnO4, 3MnO4 2-, in acidic medium 4H plus ions gives rise to 2MnO4-, that is from KMnO4, 2MnO4- permanganate ion, and along with that there is a liberation of MnO2 which we used in the beginning of the reaction, pyrolusite ore, and water is liberated. So this is a very simple reaction. First we are going to take MnO2 treated with KOH, and oxygen atom gives rise to K2MnO4, which on acidification gives rise to KMnO4. Moving further, commercially KMnO4 can be prepared by electrolytic oxidation. So here we have the setup. There is a reaction takes place at cathode and anode both. So at anode, MnO4 2- is going to convert into MnO4- and one electron is liberated. And at cathode, 2H plus ions, that is from acidic medium, 2H plus ions takes the electrons which are liberated at anode and forms H2 gas. The solution is filtered and evaporated to get deep purple colored crystals of KMnO4. Whereas in laboratory, Mn2 plus salt are oxidized by peroxo disulfate ions into permanganate ion. Equation is here. We have Mn2 plus salt, and which is treated with peroxo disulfate in presence of water gives rise to MnO4- sulfate, SO4 2- and H plus ions are liberated. A simple process. Mn plus 2 salts are converted into MnO4- or KMnO4. Moving further, next part of the video lecture, chemical and oxidizing properties of KMnO4 acidic medium. KMnO4 is a dark purple color crystalline solid, moderately soluble in water at room temperature, that is 6.4 grams per 100 gram of water at 298 Kelvin temperature. Upon heating KMnO4 at 513 Kelvin temperature, K2MnO4, that is potassium manganate, is formed, and there is a liberation of MnO2 and oxygen atoms. With this oxygen atom, we can conclude KMnO4 also acts as good oxidizing agent. Moving further, reaction with dilute H2SO4. We have KMnO4 which is treated with dilute H2SO4, which can give potassium sulfate K2SO4 and manganese sulfate MnSO4. There is a liberation of water and fine nascent oxygen atoms. Because of this nascent oxygen atoms, we can consider KMnO4 also as one of the good oxidizing agent. There is a change in oxidation number of Mn from +7 to +2. So there is a decrease in the oxidation number. The process is called as reduction. Acidified potassium permanganate KMnO4 is used as powerful oxidizing agent. Going further, oxidation of sulfide S2-2SulfurS equation MnO4 minus permanganate ion, which can give rise to Mn+2 by the gain of 5 electrons and 8 H+ ions, gives rise to 4H2O. The second equation is S2- gives rise to 2 electrons and sulfur is liberated. Just to balance the equation, we are going to multiply the second equation by 5 and first equation by 2, so that we can cancel the number of electrons of right side in the second equation with left side in the first equation. So upon simplification, we can get the final expression as 2MnO4 minus, because we are multiplying the first equation by 2, plus 16H plus ions, 8 into 2, 16H plus ions, plus 5 S2 minus ions, gives rise to 2Mn2 plus, plus 8H2O plus 5S. Where there is a change in oxidation number of Mn from +7 to +2, decrease in the oxidation number process is reduction. Whereas change in oxidation number of sulfur from -2 to 0, increase in the oxidation number in the process is oxidation. Moving to the next one, oxidation of ferrous Fe2 plus to ferric Fe plus 3. We have permanganate ion which convert into Mn2 plus by the gain of 5 electrons and 8H plus ions by the liberation of 4H2O. Second equation, Fe plus 2 gives rise to 1 electron and Fe plus 3. The second equation is multiplied by 5 so that we can cancel the electrons of left side, the first equation, and the right side of second equation. So the final equation what we get is MnO4 minus plus 5 Fe2 plus plus 8 H plus ions gives rise to Mn2 plus 5 Fe plus 3 and 4 H2O molecule. Again, there is a change in the oxidation number of Mn from +7 to +2. So this arrow mark must be to Mn. The process is reduction. And change in oxidation number of Fe from +2 to +3, increase in the oxidation number, it is oxidation. Similarly, the next one, oxidation of iodide I- to iodine I2. The final equation is 2MnO4- minus plus 10 I- minus ions plus 16 H plus ions gives rise to 2Mn2 plus plus 5 I2 plus 8 H2O. So for this you can write the other two equations, that is simplified equations. The change in oxidation number of Mn from +7 to +2, reduction, and change in oxidation number of iodine from -1 to 0 is oxidation. Similarly, oxidation of oxalate ion at 333 Kelvin temperature. Here we have permanganate ion MnO4 minus reacts with 5C2O4 2-, that is oxalate ion. So oxalate ion can be obtained from oxalic acid. H2C2O4 is oxalic acid. H2C2O4 is oxalic acid, which is treated with 16 H plus ions, gives rise to 2Mn2 plus 10CO2 and 8H2O. Again, it is a simplified equation. Change in oxidation number of Mn from +7 to +2, process is reduction, and the change in oxidation number of carbon from +3 to +4, it is oxidation. Moving to the next one, oxidation of nitrite NO2- minus to nitrate NO3-. We have permanganate ion MnO4- minus plus 5 NO2- minus plus 6 H plus ions gives rise to 2Mn2 plus plus 5 NO3 minus, and along with that there is a liberation of 8 H2O molecules. The change in oxidation number of Mn from +7 to +2, decrease in the oxidation number, process is reduction. and change in oxidation number of nitrogen from +3 to +5. You can cross verify the oxidation numbers also, students. The change in oxidation number increases process is oxidation. Other common oxidation reactions of acidic KMnO4 are like this. H2S on oxidation gives rise to water and sulfur. SO2 on oxidation in presence of water gives rise to H2SO4. That is, sulfur dioxide reacts with water, undergoes oxidation, gives sulfuric acid. Next, KNO2 on oxidation gives rise to KNO3. Na2SO3 on oxidation gives rise to Na2SO4. Potassium iodide reacts with H2SO4, undergoes oxidation in presence of KMnO4, forms K2SO4, H2O, and iodine is liberated. Further, reactions with respect to hydrogen halide. Hydrogen halides undergoes oxidation in presence of KMnO4, forms water and halogen, where X is Cl, Br, I. Moving to the next part of the video lecture. Structure and uses of KMnO4. Here the structure of manganate and permanganate ions are like this. Mn at the center and 4 oxygen atoms are at the corners of tetrahedral structure. Again, there is 2 minus charge. The charge is present on 2 oxygen atoms and consolidated charge is MnO4 2-. Formula is MnO4 2-, manganate ion we call, and which is green colored substance. Whereas the other one, permanganate ion, which is also having Mn and 4 oxygen atoms at the corners of tetrahedral structure, and there is a presence of only 1 negative charge, as other 3 oxygen atoms are double bonded and only 1 oxygen atom is single bonded. Formula is MnO4-. Name of the ion is permanganate ion, and which is purple colored substance. Dear students, please remember, the first structure MnO4 2- is paramagnetic, hence it has to give the color to the substance, whereas the second one is diamagnetic, but still it gives color to the compound. Reason may be asked in the competitive exams, please remember, it is because of p orbitals of oxygen overlaps with d orbitals of manganese to form p pi bonds, that is d pi p pi bond formation, and which leads to the formation of color to the compound for MnO4-. And also Mn in MnO4- undergoes sp3 hybridization. The 4 oxygen atoms are arranged in tetrahedrally around Mn. Here Mn has +7 oxidation state and d0 configuration. D0 configuration means there are no unpaired electron in d orbital, hence it is a diamagnetic. It means it should not give the color, but still it is going to give the color, that is purple color. It's because of d pi p pi formation. So the color is appeared due to the charge transfer and not because of dd transition. We learned d block elements or the transition elements give the color because of dd transition. The lower orbital electron jump into higher energy level and comes back. That is a dd transition. But here such things are not going to happen, as there are no electron in d orbitals of Mn in KMnO4, but still gives the color because of charge transfer. Moving to the next one, uses of KMnO4. It is used as disinfectant as well as oxidizing agent in the industries and the laboratory. We use this alkaline potassium permanganate, that is alkaline KMnO4, as Bayer's reagent for detecting the presence of unsaturation in the organic compound. And it is also used in the volumetric analysis for the estimation of ferrous salts, oxalic acid, hydrogen peroxide, etc. And the KMnO4 is also used in detecting the halides in qualitative analysis, that is titrations. Thank you, dear students. Hope you enjoy the session. Thank you all.